Introducing. Wait, what am I introducing?
This is the 11-foot skull my friends and I built to terminate Bitcoin's impact on climate change.
You are terminated.
To find out why we brought this mobile monstrosity to life and understand what it's doing in a warehouse with creepy folks and red laser eyes, I need to first take you to Greenland on the second largest ice sheet in the world.
This ice sheet over here, if we go further down, is 3 kilometers deep, and all of it is melting.
Did you know that the temperature in Greenland is rising 4 times faster than the global average? This matters because if all of it were to melt, global sea levels would rise by 20 feet, and this would happen to the cities and places we all know and love. But what surprised me was this one word that kept coming up. It was...
Bitcoin.
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 And not because of its fluctuations in price, but because of its impact on ice. You see, for Bitcoin to work, large computer farms like this run all over the world, solving increasingly complex math problems to maintain and secure a record of every transaction ever made. Wasting incredible amounts of energy, powered mainly by fossil fuels. In the last half decade, Bitcoin energy consumption has now skyrocketed, so much so that it now uses as much energy as some small countries. Why? Because Satoshi Nakamoto, the anonymous person or persons who invented Bitcoin, made it wasteful by design. If you waste energy mining Bitcoin, you get rewarded. If you waste more energy mining Bitcoin, you get even more cash. And if you somehow find a way to lower the cost of energy, then you make more profit. And of course, it eventually leads to situations like this, where Bitcoin miners are reopening old coal power plants in order to make more money. Ugh. That's about when I decided to start getting involved. But before going there, I just want to make it clear that I'm not anti-Bitcoin. I am pro-environment. And since I spent the last few years highlighting issues like fast fashion, ocean plastics, and electronic waste, I wanted to find a way to create a symbol that could help accelerate change. Now, a quick search online revealed that symbols connecting Bitcoin and climate change were terrible. So I decided to take a stab by combining the symbol of death, coal smokestacks, and the laser eyes of Bitcoin. But a sketch alone wasn't enough. We had to build it. Because giant art in the hands of organizations like Greenpeace create headlines which drive change. Which meant designing something that was both lightweight and portable. My friend and mechanical engineer, Jeremy, came up with a brilliant idea to create a laser-cut CNC model that could break apart into 5 easy-to-remove parts.
Look at this amazing user manual that our engineer has created.
It all fits together so easily that even someone like me can figure it out.
This is so fun! It's coming together!
Oh my God. Love it when things work.
Voila! The skeleton of our skull is now complete. We gotta pack this all in with foam. Then we shape the whole thing.
But little did I know, that was the easy part.
Filling our skull with tiny blocks of recycled styrofoam turned out to be a lot harder than expected, especially with this technique.
Joel, do you think there's a faster way we can do this?
So we invested in this little piece of technology to help us out.
Best $150 investment ever.
One block down, 1,000 blocks to go. And once all that was done, it was time for our skull to get a cute little shave until the entire surface was silky smooth and prepare it for the most exciting part.
Covering our structure in electronic waste. Why? Because Bitcoin mining rigs break very quickly, generating a ton of electronic waste along the way. But finding large volumes of electronic waste is easier said than done. The problem with public waste collection like these is that nothing is sorted or organized. Like, what am I gonna do with this? This meant getting some help from Daddy Google, receiving a bunch of rejections like this, and finding the one yes. Meet UniRecycle, our local Willy Wonka of electronic waste, who collect giant boxes like this, breaking it down and sorting it into multiple bins.
Hard drive.
All we had to do was let them know what we wanted, get it delivered to the Activism Studio, and figure out what to do with all of this stuff.
Several days later.
The skinning of our skull is taking place in 3 key steps. 1, sorting through the e-waste to find the most beautiful greens. 2, deconstructing our e-waste to make it light and beautiful. And finally, Lena over here screws it all in, screws it all in, screws it all in, screws it all in to fix it right into place. Rinse and repeat like 50,000 times.
But as cool as the skull was, it was still missing a couple of key details. The most important being the Bitcoin laser eyes.
Ah!
In case you missed it, this was a trend that started in 2021 called laser raise to 100K. It was a way for Bitcoin advocates to signal their undying support for Bitcoin, and it gathered so much momentum that even celebrities like Tom Brady and Paris Hilton changed their profile pictures to show their support. And although the fad has largely passed since Bitcoin never actually hit 100K, laser eyes as a symbol for blind faith in Bitcoin was too perfect to pass up. So we found a set of disco lights, a vertical smoke machine, and this giant home power 2 battery pack to power the entire thing, and had this magical moment with the entire team.
Laser eyes!
Yeah!
Smokestacks are smoking.
But we weren't done yet. Even though we're in Canada in the middle of winter, we knew that we had to take some epic photos because most of you are never going to get a chance to see my Skull of Satoshi in the real world. But finding access to a large abandoned warehouse like the one that Bitcoin miners are buying up is not that easy. I got lucky by reaching out to a demolition company called Delsun AIM, and they had the perfect spot that, fortunately for me, didn't have a demolition permit just yet. It was a huge space with long, creepy hallways, and thanks to this AR model that my friend Manu created, I was able to figure out exactly where to put the skull and plan what photos we wanted to take with each one. With our skull successfully loaded into the truck, location secured, nothing could stop us now.
Except for a tiny snowstorm and some terrible driving skills.
Stupid U-Haul without snow tires.
Our plan was to capture three distinct photos. The first, you already saw. A pack of anonymous computer warriors, complete with red laser eyes that we made using small strings of fairy lights.
Perfect. Oh, you guys look like a cult. This is amazing. This is exactly what I wanted.
The message here isn't to say that all people who support Bitcoin are bad. On the contrary, it is to highlight the power that the legion of Bitcoin believers have to turn against Satoshi's wasteful legacy and demand change. The second is to highlight the corporate interests that are currently entangled in the business of supporting Bitcoin. These suits have both the capital and influence necessary to demand a more environmentally friendly Bitcoin from the community. And the last is the everyday person like you and me who want to protect themselves from the environmental impact of Bitcoin. Our job is the simplest, to share this problem with the world and create demand for Bitcoin to change its code.
Okay, this is the part where you come in. Bitcoin has updated its code many, many times in the past and will continue to do so into the future. So why not make sure that the next iteration of code is less wasteful? Since Bitcoin is decentralized, popularity matters. And making sure that people are demanding a more sustainable Bitcoin is crucial to make sure that it even gets adopted. You can also follow Greenpeace, who's going to be taking this skull to demand that corporations and governments stop supporting Bitcoin until it becomes more environmentally sustainable. I don't know exactly what they're gonna do with it, but usually it's pretty entertaining, so fingers crossed. And last but not least, if you or anyone you know are interested in using your creativity to make some noise, head over to the link below where we've created a guide on how you can get involved. At the end of the day, the reason I'm doing all of this is for the next generation. This little guy is my nephew, and he is the reason why I'm pro-environment. I want him to grow up in a world where the planet isn't drowning because we weren't able to get some insatiable technology under control. And while I know that fixing Bitcoin is not going to solve the climate crisis, it's going to be one less thing for the next generation to have to worry about. We have an opportunity right now to terminate Bitcoin's impact on climate change. And with your help, we can make that happen. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bloopers and credits coming right up.
I'm an artist.
Oh, no, he looks good. He looks like he's got butt teeth.